Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, this is Hemalata from Purnavidyashram. Today's session is from Social and Political Life 1, Chapter 4, Key Elements of a Democratic Government. In this chapter, we'll read about some of the key elements that influence the working of a democratic government. These includes people's participation, the resolution of conflict, and equality and justice. Before we study about people's participation, resolution, conflict, equality and justice, we will have a small story in the book about the people who suffered due to racial discrimination. What kind of difficulties people faced during those periods, these were mentioned in this story. South Africa is a country that has people of several races. So there are black people who belong to South Africa, whites who came there to settle, and Indians who came as laborers and traders. So South Africa is the largest country. There are several races. What is races? People belong to different places, different kinds. They are called as races. So people lived there were black people. So the black people were people who belongs to South Africa, and whites who came and settled there, and Indians also there who worked as laborers and also traders were there in South Africa. Maya Naidu, an 11-year-old South African girl living in the town of Johannesburg. She was helping her mother to clear up her old boxes. Then she found a scrapbook full of pictures and newspaper articles which were collected by her mother. There were many pictures of a young schoolboy of around 15 years of age. When she asked her mother who the boy was, she told that he was called Hector Nluvu. He had been shot by the police. Maya was shocked. Why? She asked. Her mother explained that South Africa was earlier governed by apartheid laws. Apartheid means separation on the basis of race. South African people were divided into white, black, Indian, and colored races. According to the law, these races were not allowed to mingle with each other, to live near each other, or even to use common facilities. Apartheid means racial discrimination. So in South Africa, people were divided according to their race, color. So this law says that the races were not allowed to mingle with each other. They should not live near each other, or even they should not use the common facilities. Maya could not believe her ears. Maya's mother sounded angry when she spoke about life under apartheid because it was very difficult days. She told Maya that in those days, hospitals were separate and so were ambulances also. An ambulance meant for white people would have always be well equipped, while one meant for black people was not. There were separate trains and buses for also. So even the bus stops were different for black and white people. Non-whites were not allowed to vote. The best land in the country was reserved for the white people, and non-whites had to live on the worst available land. So thus, blacks and colored people were not considered to be equal to whites. The white people who went and settled in the places of South Africans, then they started to subjugate the South Africans in the races. The black were not allowed to live a good life and healthy life. While the white people, they took over the land of the South Africans, they lived a well-equipped life. They had all the facilities which were available in that South Africa. So the blacks were never treated equally. They did not have their voting right also. So there will be no changes in these kind of laws like apartheid. There was a black township. It was the Southwestern Township or Soweto. Hector Nluvu lived here, and he and his classmates joined the protest against learning the Afrikaans language in school. Afrikaans language is the language which was used by whites to speak. The whites forced them to study Afrikaans language, but they had their own language. Africans spoke their own mother tongue, but the white people prohibited to learn their own language. Hector and other school students were being forced to learn this Afrikaans language, but they wanted to learn their own language called Zulu. The South African police beat up the protesters mercilessly and shot at the crowd. So one of their bullets killed Hector. This was happened on 30th of April 1976. Hector and other school students really wanted to study in their own language, but they were forced to learn Afrikaans language. So in the protest, police, they beat up all the protesters mercilessly and shot at the crowd. So this is the incident shows how cruelly the people and even the small children were treated during those early days. Then after that, the African National Congress, a group of people who led the struggle against the apartheid, and their most well-known leader is Nelson Mandela. He fought the apartheid system for several years. Finally, they succeeded, and in 1994, South Africa became a democratic country in which people of all races were considered equal. In our previous session, we had studied how people, the poor people, women fought to get their writing vote in India. And also we studied about USA, UK, the women were protesting for their writing votes. But in South Africa, it was a different situation. The apartheid law prohibited everyone except the whites. The whites hold the maximum power in South Africa. Now, let us try to understand what a democratic government means to all of us. First, participation should be there. So the people will elect the leader among themselves. For that, the people have to participate in the election. Why do we have a regular elections? We had already read in previous chapter that people make the decisions in a democratic country. How? By voting. Through voting in elections, people elect leaders to represent them. So these representatives take decisions on behalf of people. In doing so, it is assumed that they will keep in mind the voices and interests of the people, and they will execute every need of the people according to the interest of the people. So all governments are elected for fixed periods. In India, this period is for 5 years. Once elected, governments can stay in power only for that period, which is for 5 years in India. If they want to continue to be in power, then they have to be re-elected by the people through the election, which will be conducted every 5 years. This is a moment when people can sense their power in a democracy. The people will analyze the actions of the government and their good doings during the period of their governance. So if they are a good governance, then people will re-elect them, or else they have the power to change the government by voting to different candidate. In this way, the power of the government gets limited by regular elections. There are other ways of participating in the election too. Elections are usually held once in 5 years. Besides voting, there are other ways of participating in the process of government. What is that? People participate by taking an interest in the working of the government and by criticizing it when required. First is participating in government by elections. It is the direct participation of the people. There are other ways also. What is that? Working of the government and by criticizing the government. When people criticize the government, what will happen? The government will understand the problem of the people. When there are negative comments, by criticizing them, we are pointing out the mistakes which had been done by them. So through that, they will learn the mistakes which were made by them and they will correct it. So in August 2005, when a particular government increased the money people had to pay for electricity, people expressed their disapproval very sharply. So they took out rallies and also organized a signature campaign. What is a signature campaign? People will sign during a campaign and they will post the letter which will be mentioned clearly about the problem and criticization of the government, and then it will be sent to the government. So it is the signature campaign. The government tried to explain and defend its decision, but finally listened to the people's opinion and withdrew the increase of the electricity bill. So this shows the power of the people. Once the people elected their representative, the process will not get over. The people will be active in the government by criticizing it during necessary time. The government had to change its decision because it is responsible to the people. People express their views by different ways to make the government understand what action they should take for problems. So these include dharnas, rallies, strikes, signature campaigns, etc. So things that are unfair and unjust are also brought forward. Newspapers, magazines and TV also play a role in discussing government issues and responsibilities. So these are the ways people show their protest against the action of the government, which cannot be accepted by the people. While it is true that a democracy allows people to participate, it is also true that not all sections of people are actually able to do so. Another way for people to participate is by organizing themselves into social movements that seek to challenge the government and its functionings. Members of the minority community, Dalits, Adivasis, women and others are often able to participate in this manner. So the people who are in small population, what they will do, they will form social movements. They will become a small movements. They join together and they will show their protest if any action was took against them. If a country's people are alert and interested in how the country is run, the democratic character of the government of that country will be very strong. So they have to be criticizing. The people have to criticize the government and their actions. Then only a stronger and powerful democratic country will exist. This is a picture about the headlines. So this will gives us a good idea about what approval or disapproval is being expressed here. So this picture is about the water scarcity of a place. Not bad, one of the taps in the nearby village must be getting water. This picture expresses the difficulty of the people during water scarcity. During water scarcity, what will happen? People will not get enough water, isn't it? So this shows the difficulty of the people and expresses the people's view that they need good water facility. These pictures are the letters to the editor that people sent to the newspapers. So this picture is about banning the posters in New Delhi. The posters on walls spoil the city's look. Further, many times posters are pasted on important signboards and even road maps. All political parties should arrive at a consensus on banning posters on walls. So this shows the interest of that person in his environment. So he wanted his city to be very clean and neat. So he expressed his view about banning posters to this newspaper. Another poster is take action. So this is a letter which was sent to the editor regarding the tiger population. It is worrying to know that the tiger population in India is falling. Tigers are being hunted and killed by poachers for their skins. The government has not taken the issue of poaching seriously enough. It must take action immediately, arrest the poachers and implement the laws protecting the tiger. If this does not happen, the tiger will become an extinct animal in the next 10 years. People are worrying about their environment. So after this, what happened? The government had took initiative regarding these problems which was faced by the people. Necessary laws were created by the government to take action on these issues. Then another need is government must give compensation to flood victims. So the people who was affected by the flood, they want compensation from the government. So these were the people who expressed their needs through the newspapers to government. People also expressed their views by dharnas, rallies, strikes, signature campaigns, etc. And also we saw some newspaper clippings and through magazines also. In TV, the people will discuss about the actions of the government and the needs of the people. So these are the rights, freedom of the people to express their views on behalf of the people to the government. In our next session, we will study about how to resolve the conflicts and the equality and justice.